welcome, everybody. Welcome to The Tonight Show. This afternoon, President Biden received his COVID booster shot on camera in front of reporters. When they offered Biden a booster, he said, "I'll take one in my arm and another for my approval rating." Biden getting the booster shot wasn't too exciting. It was watching them try to roll up his sleeve right before. That's where all the action was. Take a look at this. This is real.
Is that high enough for you? She's gonna get one. She's gonna get one. Yes.
Mr. President, what do you say to the World Health leaders that, like, the World Health Organization is saying?
I've changed a diaper and dressed a baby faster than that. It looked like she was torturing his arm for information. Like, who sent you? After that, one sleeve looked perfectly ironed. The other looked like he fell off a motorcycle going 80 miles an hour. Later, Biden was checked for a hernia and tried rolling his pant leg over his waist. Eventually, the Secret Service pulled a woman away when Biden's arm popped out of its socket. She's like, that's more than enough. Rolling up a sleeve over your shoulder is impossible. It's easier to get a Casper mattress back in its packaging. How did this arrive in this box? Some COVID news yesterday. The CEO of Pfizer said that he believes that life will return to normal within a year. That's right. That's right. By this time next year, Americans can go back to normal activities like storming Area 51 and eating Tide Pods. That's what we were doing. That was our normal 2 years ago. Those were the headlines. Yet the CEO of Pfizer said he expects life to return to normal within a year. And that's not all he said. Check out this news story that shared his full quote here.
The CEO of Pfizer this morning is expressing some optimism by saying, quote, "I truly believe by next September, we'll be able to do whatever we want. Go to the movies. Go bowling. Let a stranger sneeze in your mouth. Anything is possible. I, for one, am going to get blitzed on White Claw, then play tongue chicken with randos at Daytona Beach. Hashtag fall freak. Hashtag sloppy September."
It's tongue chicken? I've never heard of tongue chicken. That can't be real.
Wow. I think that was a comical.
Yeah, that must not be real, yeah. Well, guys, get this. This is real. Vladimir Putin had to self-isolate after being exposed to COVID, right? So the Kremlin released some photos of him on vacation to prove that he's feeling great. And I think it worked. Here's a couple of photos here. Here's one of him sitting on a rock. And here's another one of him leaning against a tree. It looks like he's in Russia's newest reality show, Bachelor in Siberia. He looks like a catalog model for L.L. Borscht. He looks like a dad whose gift card to Filson was about to expire.
Yeah, give me the Outback hat. I'll take the waterproof jacket, too. What else? Give me the... I'll throw in the camouflage wallet. I can't let... Can't let the animals see you have a real wallet in the woods. Only problem with camouflage wallet is if I drop it. You know what I'm saying? I know you're not that.
I'm taking too much of your time. Those look like photos you'd post with the caption, "Hey guys, I'm taking a break from social media for a while." That's right. Russia released the pictures as soon as they were able to find a photographer willing to go into the Siberian wilderness with Vladimir Putin. It's like, yeah, I'm busy that weekend. Speaking of world leaders, Germany just held its federal election, which means that after more than 16 years in office, German Chancellor Angela Merkel will soon step down. Yep. Merkel's staff loved her until she demanded they come to her goodbye Zoom happy hour. No one likes that. Meanwhile, in her last few days before the election, Merkel, this is real, she visited a park and decided to feed some birds. Here's a photo, right? And here she is a few minutes after. That's every kid in line for the haunted house and then inside the haunted house. You know what I'm saying? In hindsight, it might have been a mistake to wear a perfume called Stale Bread. It's pronounced Stale.
Stale.
Yeah. Stale Bread. Some more news from overseas this weekend. South Korea asked North Korea to restore the emergency hotline between the two countries. When asked for comment, Kim Jong-un was like, damn, everyone wants my digits now that I got a banging bod.
That's what he said?
That's a quote, apparently, yeah.
Wow.
North Korea actually wants to restore the hotline, but every time they pick up the phone, the entire country loses the internet. Hey, do you guys remember the SpaceX all-tourist flight earlier, a couple weeks ago? Well, it turns out while they were in orbit, an alarm in the capsule went off due to a suction problem with the toilet. They called the space plumber who said that he'll be there somewhere between the spring and winter solstice. Can you narrow down anymore? I gotta work. Yet the crew had to be taught how to fix it, so basically it was a bunch of NASA scientists saying,
this is Mission Control. Have you tried jiggling the handle, maybe?
Meanwhile, you know one crew member kept trying to sell it like, I swear it was broken when I walked in there. Frank, there's only four of us in space. It's all right. I get this, a new study found that regular sauna use has many of the same benefits as exercise. The only difference is I don't have to see eight strangers' testicles when I lift weights.
You don't have to.
Yeah. And finally, this video made me, you'll see. Two girls in Missouri hit a squirrel with their car, and they were so upset that they tried to try and save it. This is real, watch this.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Turns out the squirrel wasn't dead. He was just in shock after she drove over his nuts. Today, Amazon held a big event where it announced a ton of new products, but this is the one that everybody's talking about. It's a $999 robot named Astro that roams around your house. Check this thing out. Yeah. It looks like an iPad, an HP printer, and a Roomba had a threesome. It's called Astro, as in, remember Grandpa? He broke his hip when he tripped over Astro. Amazon also said you can ask Astro to do silly things like dance, which is fun until Astro's like, now you dance or I'll leak your search history. Here's a video of Astro in action. Let's take a look. Yep, for $1,000, they made a cup holder with wheels. It's amazing.
What?
That's your reaction to the
reaction.
What? It's very simple. All you have to do is go in the kitchen, get a beer, put it in on the robot, go back in the couch, wait 30 seconds for the robot to roll over with your beer. It's kind of, and then go, what? Well, get this, I saw that the U.S. Post Office announced that its mail delivery is about to get slower and more expensive.
What? And that
it seems like the changes have already gotten into effect because they mailed out that announcement 2 months ago. Meanwhile, AT&T is furious. They're like, hey, slower and more expensive is our slogan. Yeah, the Post Office is implementing new service standards for first-class mail and periodicals. That's how you know the Post Office is antiquated. They call magazines periodicals. Well, guys, there's a lot of drama in Washington, D.C. right now because if Congress doesn't pass a funding bill by midnight Thursday, the government will shut down. You can tell Biden's stressed. Today, Astro was bringing him shots of Jameson.
What?
If there is a shutdown, that means TSA agents will probably have to work without pay. It'll be weird when a TSA agent is patting you down like, I'm not in it for the money. I saw that tomorrow Congress is drafting a bill to legalize marijuana. Yeah, that's how bad the country needs money right now. We're like, I guess we gotta start selling drugs. You guys hear about this? There's a new tell-all book about President Trump. Yeah. It's a new one now. It's written by his former press secretary, Stephanie Grisham. And it's full of weird revelations. Like, apparently, back in 2019, Trump's secret trip to the hospital was so that he can get a colonoscopy. Yeah. Colonoscopy was no big deal. They only found 3 polyps and Rudy Giuliani. Oh. Got him right out. The book also says a White House official known as the Music Man would play Trump his favorite show tunes, like Memory from Cats, to pull him from the brink of rage. It makes sense, because Trump's presidency is exactly like Cats. Awkward, bizarre, and no one had any idea what the hell was going on. Yep, Trump listened to Cats to cheer himself up, while the rest of his staff remained Les Miserables. Some entertainment news. According to new data released by Netflix, people spent 625 million hours watching Bridgerton in the first month it was released. What's even crazier is one aunt in Dayton, Ohio, accounted for 600 million of those hours by herself. And finally, a man in the UK looks so much like Ed Sheeran, he has to go around in disguise to escape fans. Here's a photo of the man on the right. Well, one thing you could do is not style your hair exactly like Ed Sheeran. Right now, that guy's girlfriend of 2 years is like, wait, you're not Ed Sheeran? The CDC will soon decide whether it's okay to mix and match booster shots from different vaccines. Amazing. Who knew we could mix and match vaccines like tops and bottoms at Old Navy? So this means if you got Moderna, you can get Pfizer. If you got Pfizer, you can get Moderna. And if you got Johnson & Johnson, then you should get both. Meanwhile, I saw that the FDA is leaning towards authorizing the Moderna booster at a half dose. I guess Moderna is really strong. I've never seen the vial, but apparently it looks like one of those energy drink cans with a tiger on the side. Lightning bolt. The FDA also said if you need help watering down the Moderna shot, you can couple it with the Johnson & Johnson. That's not true. Some more vaccine news. YouTube just announced that it is blocking all anti-vaccine content. But don't worry, if you want anti-vaccine content, just check out the comment section of literally any video. Meanwhile, the vaccination deadline for United Airlines employees just passed, and now the company is preparing to let go of nearly 600 workers who did not get vaccinated. Some employees are so mad about being kicked out that they're duct taping themselves to the seats. Yep, they told unvaccinated employees, look, you can't work for United if you're positive for Delta. Some news out of Washington. I saw that the government will run out of money in less than 3 weeks unless Congress raises the debt ceiling. And some people in Washington are already trying to find part-time jobs in case the government ends up shutting down for a while.
Really?
Yeah. For example, Congressman Raul Ruiz applied to be the new Gerber baby. You have to get another job.
Yeah, you got to risk it to get the biscuit.
Yeah. Up next, Congressman Rick Crawford applied to be the baritone in an old-timey barbershop quartet.
Mother, you call her Daisy.
Up next, Congressman Mike Quigley applied to be a Budweiser frog. Wait, that's not it. Can you be that? Can you be that? I don't...
Bud.
Wise. Up next, Congressman Don Young applied to be a mall Santa. That's nice. while Congressman David Schweikert applied to be his elf. Here's another one. Congressman Derek Kilmer applied to be Beaker in a live-action Muppet movie. That's... Did you have to put the... I don't think you need to put the side-by-side there. Next, Senator John Tester applied to be a high school football coach who gets banned after sucker-punching a referee. And finally, Senator Mitch McConnell applied to be the new James Bond. But I don't know. We don't know. We'll wait and see who's going to be the new James Bond. Some entertainment news. ABC has named Jesse Palmer as the new host of The Bachelor.
Oh.
Yeah, today Jesse said, "I've dreamed about this job ever since I found out how much it paid." Yep, Jesse Palmer is the new Bachelor host, but before he got hired, he and all the other candidates had to fill out an application, and the questions they asked were pretty interesting. For instance, a potential Bachelor host were asked, "Can you tell the difference between six different women named Lauren?" Next up, "Do you have the stamina to work 7 minutes a week?" Next up, "Are you comfortable putting crying drunk people in the back of a limo to the airport?" And finally, "Have you ever sat next to a screaming bachelorette party and thought, I want to do this for a living?" See, these are smart questions for the Bachelor. And some more TV news. After 11 years off the air, NBC is bringing back the original Law and Order for a 21st season. At this point, when there's a body in Central Park, like six different Law & Order casts show up to investigate. Well, last night in London, it was the world premiere of the new James Bond movie, No Time to Die. It's great. There was even some royalty in attendance. Here's a photo of Kate, Prince William, Camilla, Prince Charles on the red carpet. Unfortunately, Queen Elizabeth couldn't make it. She was in the next theater screening Venom, Let There Be Carnage. Hey, guys, get this. Today is National Coffee Day. Yeah. And it's a good thing, too, because I can't get enough of the stuff. I mean, don't talk to me until I have my coffee.
Same here, Jimbo. I don't want to hear a sound until I've had my brown.
Yeah, I'm like, no blah blah till I get that Java.
There will be no chit-chat until I hit that.
Yeah, just sit tight while I sip my flat white.
I can't hear what you say over my cafe au lait.
Don't come at me with your stresso till I chug my espresso.
You don't let her rip until I get that drip.
Don't want to hear chirp till I get that slurp.
No time for riff-raff while I'm sipping decaf. Wait a minute, decaf?
Just stay at home till I finish that foam.
You'll get your cue
when there's no cold brew.
You can talk plenty
when I've got my venti.
Won't hear your crap
until I drink my frap.
There ain't no speaking
until I'm tweaking.
I shan't be seen
before I drink my bean.
Drink,
yay.
Chat,
nay.
Happy
National
Coffee Day.
Hey. I don't know how it happened. Hey, I read that the owner of a circus in Ireland is struggling to hire clowns because apparently they all left the country during the pandemic. You can tell the clowns were Irish because they just left without telling anyone. Irish. And finally, this is going viral. Someone caught a video of a Florida man calmly dealing with a pretty stressful situation. Watch this. Yeah, in Florida, that's actually how you become governor. As the push to get more Americans vaccinated continues, today, AstraZeneca announced that its vaccine was found to be 74% effective in the company's latest U.S. trial. 74%. Americans told AstraZeneca, I think you guys need to do more of your own research. 74, yeah. On the bright side, it's 100% effective at making Johnson & Johnson feel better about their vaccine. Hey. We're in the high 70s. 76. 74% isn't great. I mean, even horse dewormer is at 75%.
Really?
Yeah. But here's some good news. Just hours ago, Congress passed a bill before the midnight deadline to avoid a government shutdown. That's right. The bill will keep the government funded through early December. Smart. Figure this out around the holidays when things are less stressful. I totally agree. That's right. Congress is giving the federal government another 2 months to figure it out. They sound less like lawmakers, more like bookies.
You got 2 months. You got 2 months to figure this out, all right? When I come back, I'll bring a baseball bat.
That's right, Congressman.
Did you get stung by a bee? Like,
what do you mean? What do you mean?
Baseball, but you baseball.
No, that's what I didn't get the call back from my audition for the new Sopranos movie, but
I thought it was
Many
Jerry
Saints
Lewis.
Of Newark. Yeah,
that was
I just
Jerry Lewis. Though.
But when I come back, I'm gonna bring my baseball back.
You know, it's confusing because you go, you feel threatened,
right?
You feel threatened, but it's also well, it's kind of funny.
Yeah, right. They let him down.
Yeah, exactly. A little.
Whoa.
Yeah, I could do it the other way. Like,
you got 2 months. I was gonna bring my baseball bat.
That's scary.
Yeah. Whatever the director wants, yeah. I can do.
You get it, man.
Yeah, I can hit all. I can do everything. You edit. You know.
Are you be scared? Do it when you're scared. Like you're scared, Tone.
I'm scared.
Yeah, you're scared.
You got 2 months. Then I'll be back with the baseball bat. But Congress may have narrowly avoided a shutdown, but their infrastructure bill is still in peril, and they might run out of money soon. Everyone in Washington is stressed out, and some members of Congress have even started releasing statements about the whole thing. For example, Congressman David Price said, if we don't work together, the American people will pay the ultimate, well, my last name. Next up, Congressman Josh Harder said, we Democrats are trying to help, but the GOP is making everything, well... My last name. Then Congressman Tom Reed was like, does anyone even look at these bills? Sometimes I wonder if my colleagues can't even, well, my last name. Congressman Jeff Duncan said, we're gonna stay up all night to fix this thing. I'll bring the coffee because America runs on, well, my last name. Then Senator John Ossoff said, some people don't seem to be trying at all. Meanwhile, I'm over here working my little, well, my last name. Congressman Pat Fallon said, maybe if we fix things, we'll be invited to appear on The Tonight Show starring Jimmy, well, my last name. Then Congresswoman Anna Eshoo said, I know we can get this done, so let's hammer this out and sneeze coming hot, my last name. And finally, Congressman Dutch Ruppersberger said, no comment. The man of few words. Yeah, it's been a big week for lawmakers. Last night was the annual congressional baseball game with Democrats facing off against Republicans at Nationals Park. It was just baseball, no politics, until the Republican catcher went nuts about having to wear a mask. Just baseball. This was fun. President Biden stopped by for the game, although it was a little creepy when he left by disappearing into a cornfield. And get this, as if we weren't dealing with enough here, I read that the price of bacon has skyrocketed to a 40-year high. Now, when you order a Bacon King at the Burger King drive-thru, they're like, please pull your Maserati up to the second window. Let's get to the big news today. I read that McDonald's is officially bringing back the McRib nationwide, folks. When asked how they're bringing back the McRib during a pork shortage, McDonald's said, those two things aren't as related as you think. So and finally, I heard about an artist in Denmark who was commissioned by a museum for some paintings, but he decided to go a different route with the project. Watch this.
A new piece of art at a museum in Denmark has caused a stir between management and the artist, and it looks like a blank canvas. That's because it is. The museum lent him $84,000 to fill those empty frames. Instead, the artist sent empty frames and called the work Take the Money and Run.
Yeah, the artist is actually Banksy's lazy cousin, Blanksy. Guys, actually, it is a big weekend for the NFL. Everyone's talking about this. For the first time since he left for Tampa Bay, Tom Brady is returning to New England to face the Patriots. Yeah. And then after the game, he'll walk out of the stadium while Patriots fans cling to his legs like little kids. Like, don't go, please. Brady's been playing for a long time. And Brady's so old, when they do the coin toss, he's going to pretend he found it in the ref's ear. Brady's so old, he's the only person on the field who's able to get the Pfizer booster. Amazing.
Wow.
Yeah. He's so old, he calls peeing the two-minute drill. I don't know why. I don't know what that means. Brady's been around so long that during his career, The Sopranos started, ended, and came back. Brady will return to his old stadium to face the Patriots. It's going to be an emotional night for the fans, and they've already made some signs for the game. Check these out. This one says, "Why did I pay $1,000 to see my ex?" This next one says, "You left us for Florida? That's like leaving Target for Walmart." And finally, this one says, "At least give us joint custody of Gronk." A very emotional weekend. Changing gears, there's some big news in the fight against COVID. Researchers are developing vaccine patches that could replace shots. A patch is perfect. You literally get vaxxed and waxed.
Ow.
Seriously, a patch is great. It's gonna be fun when everyone thinks your 8-year-old is trying to quit smoking. Now when your crazy uncle comes over for Thanksgiving, you can just slap it on the back of his neck. It's like, good to see you, Uncle. Keep doing your research. Keep doing your research. Going well? Meanwhile, drug maker Merck announced today that it's created the first pill to treat COVID symptoms. Yep, and to get anti-vaxxers to take it, each pill's got a little picture of a horse on it.
Oh.
Yeah, as we speak, Merck is throwing the pills at people on carnival cruises like it's Mardi Gras. Oh, I saw that this week, former Vice President Mike Pence was on a podcast, and he said that he's spoken to Trump about a dozen times since Biden took office. I'm surprised they speak that much. I mean, because, you know, they both see the call coming in and be like, ugh, this freaking guy. Hello. But the real highlight of the podcast came later. Listen to what Pence said about, asked about what his favorite meal would be.
If you could choose your last meal on Earth,
come on,
what would it be?
Supreme pizza and O'Doul's. That would send me to heaven smiling.
Indiana pizza and non-alcoholic beer. I'd be ready for death, too, I think. I guess? Yeah, I have a feeling Mike Pence's bachelor party was doing a jigsaw puzzle on a Wednesday. Some business news. The CEO and co-founder of Whole Foods is stepping down after 41 years. Yeah, he finally saved up enough to buy a beach house in Miami or one sliced grapefruit at Whole Foods. Hey, get this. Someone just paid $3,000 at an auction for underwear that was worn by Michael Jordan.
What?
You can hear more about Jordan's underwear in the new ESPN documentary, The Last Pants. And finally, a man in Texas was pulled over because he was driving in a carpool lane with a Halloween skeleton in the passenger seat. And to avoid the ticket, the driver told the skeleton, quick, switch seats with me. Quick.